It is the third Saturday in October in the SEC, and that should mean something to college football fans across the nation. Maybe it's lost a lot of luster nationally in recent years, but it's still Tennessee and Alabama with the Vols coming in at 3-3. We bring in Mike LaValle from Last Word on College Football. You can join him right there for the best in college football coverage with a focus on Tennessee football. Mike, how you doing tonight?
Doing great, Mark, as always. Thanks for having me on.
Yes, thank you. I know you've got a lot going, so I appreciate you jumping on board here. Let's talk Tennessee football. I caught probably three quarters of the game against South Carolina. I was impressed with Garantano's last drive up until the point in which they reached the red zone. The rush defense against the South Carolina running game that's been anemic pretty much fell into place in regards to what the season has been defensively in that portion of the defensive effort. Your thoughts about the South Carolina game?
Well, yeah, for the second year in a row, Tennessee loses to South Carolina coming off of a bye. South Carolina, I think, had three starting offensive linemen out of the game. They had two starting wide receiver out for the year. They lost their number one running back during the game. Just a completely inexcusable loss, just like last year's loss to South Carolina coming off a bye. As far as Guarantano's performance, I thought he did pretty good moving the ball. He did better throwing the ball than what I thought, had some authority. Ran the ball well, made two first downs, really showed that he's a better fit for that scheme, for that offense. But, you know, he needs some improvement as well. Biggest area improvement is decision-making. He had a brutal decision in the red zone, I believe, on the third time they were in the red zone, where he rolled out on a pass and then ran out of bounds instead of throwing the ball out and cost Tennessee instead of a third and goal from, I believe, the four, or third and goal from the six, maybe. It was now third and goal from the 12. And then he was pressured, had the ball stripped out twice during the last drive, and had to check down a lot in the passing game. So his decision-making as far as the downfield passing game leaves a lot to be desired. But overall, solid start against, you know, quite frankly, a South Carolina team that earned the victory but is not nearly as strong as that victory would indicate. Certainly is not going to be good enough for this week at Alabama.